Greg Sims is the producer of a documentary called All 6 Feet. It comes out in 6 weeks. And it's the real story of Lana Clarkson. He was listening and called in. Greg, thank you very much for calling. I appreciate it.
Hi, Larry. I actually listen to your show, and I respect you, even though we have different opinions sometimes.
Well, thanks, Greg. I try to do a show where I don't demean people because they disagree with me, and try to do a show where I can explore ideas and hopefully make things better. That's my goal. And whenever I hear somebody disagrees with me but still listens to the show, I think maybe, just maybe, I might even be achieving that.
Absolutely. And if I can just say, we're actually shooting in 6 weeks, and it's not a documentary, it's a feature. It's really the other story, the different story than the one HBO is telling.
Now, have you seen the HBO one, Greg?
No, I read the HBO piece early on, which was part of the reason that I decided to make this movie.
Mm-hmm. Well, what is the real story of Lana Clarkson?
Well, the real story that we're telling is the story of her relationship with Pumpkin Pie, who was her best friend for 9 years, even though when Pie testified in court, she was the subject of a lot of criticism and a lot of people saying she had taken money and lied, which, you know, I, of course, came to the conclusion was definitely not true. I kept saying no, I wasn't going to be involved in doing anything that dealt with the subject because it was a tragedy. But after the second trial, I testified in both, and I saw who was coming at me and what they were trying to say about me, including accusing me of having been on a take with Phil Spector, somebody who I had never even met until I was in the elevator after the second trial. When I realized what the story was, and I can tell you in a nutshell, the story is really about a beautiful woman who, in our movie, you're certainly going to come to love and care about, but who was very flawed and who never found the fame. She never found anything to fill the fame that she never really got and never was really able to sustain. And so it's much more about why that person would go with someone like Phil Spector to his home, you know, in the middle of the night, and not so much about whether he did it or she did it, although we all have our opinions about what we think happened.
Mm-hmm. Greg, from talking to spokesperson for this group that's protesting this HBO movie, my impression is that the movie is suggesting that maybe the evidence is not so definitive that Phil Spector, in fact, killed Lana Clarkson.
Correct. Well, you asking my opinion?
Yeah.
Yeah, I came to believe when I was subpoenaed, and by the way, I was a hostile witness. My background, I've done some high-end indie movies. I've played Amanda Peet and Michael Vartan, a movie called Touch Me, which was an opening film for Toronto. I mean, real movies, not schlock. And when I was subpoenaed, they told me, we know you don't want to be here, but we really believe the science supports the our position that he's innocent. It is my opinion that, in no uncertain terms, he was put on trial for being a bad guy and an unstable guy, which clearly he is. I am not a friend of his. I've never been a friend of his. I'm not on his side or anyone's side. But my opinion, after quite a few years of looking at it, is that there's a very good chance of a couple of things that may have happened that would have involved her being responsible, whether it was intentional or an accident. And I really believe that the science seemed to show that, but they were determined that O.J. and Robert Blake, two guys who clearly murdered their wives and got away with it, they were determined to not have that happen again.
Mm-hmm. So, Greg, it sounds to me like you're taking issue with my prior guest, Edward Lodi, who suggests that the evidence is slam dunk that Phil Spector murdered Lana Clarkson. You're suggesting that maybe it isn't quite so slam dunk, and therefore it suggests to me that the anger that the friends of Lana Clarkson have might be misplaced.
Well, it's clearly misplaced, and I can tell you one thing. I brought a writer named Leslie Kingan, who I've known for decades. She wrote Photoplay, a movie Francis Coppola was going to make many years ago with Martha Coolidge directing. She is a wonderful writer. She spent a year researching thousands of pages of court transcripts. Everything in our movie is taken either directly from court transcript or it's taken from situations that had quite a few first and second-hand accounts, and there's nothing, I mean, I'm proud that what we're making is going to tell the real story, and it's going to be an honest story, and it's not a black and white story, but if people knew what they're going to see in our film, and if they had access to what I've had access to that was never allowed into court, I don't believe for a second that anyone would have really not had reasonable doubt, particularly about the science. And my understanding is, you know, if there was reasonable doubt about the science, then the ruling should have been not guilty on reasonable doubt. And I think that he was
he is not a likable guy. I can say that to you, and I say it to anybody. I don't know him personally. I have friends that I can tell you somebody I talked to the other day, a very famous rock singer, who he pulled a gun on in the dressing room when the lights went off accidentally because he was completely freaked out. But at the end of the day, this was a trial based on this case, and he had no reason to do that to her. And if people know what really went on, what condition she was in, what condition he was in, the real issue is would they have ruled reasonable doubt, as they did as the first trial was a hung jury, you know? And, yeah.
Well, I appreciate it. Greg Sims has been my guest, producer of All 6 Feet. It's the real story of Lana Clarkson. Is it going to be a theatrical film, Greg?
It is. Mm-hmm. It is. Vincent Spano, the actor who you probably know from Alive and from Baby It's You and from Rumblefish, a couple of his movies, is making his feature directing debut with this movie. And he's going to do an amazing job. And everybody's committed to telling the truth and to telling a really important story in a way that's real and not taking sides, per se.
Well, Greg Sims, I really appreciate the call. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Eric. Take care. Good talking to you.